All right. Cheers to the vinyl community, the people who are just strolling through YouTube. What's up? All right. So I'm laying on the porch. Now, my whole theme for 2022 is, I already listen to a lot of music, but I want to buy less, listen more. I feel like because of the pandemic, a lot of us were at home a little bit more. So I feel like we bought more records because we were watching more vinyl channels, which is nothing wrong with that. Had a great time. But I just feel like overall, the main reason I got into collecting vinyl wasn't to collect vinyl. It was to listen to collect music, you know. And my advice to anyone is it's not how many records you've bought, it's how much money you saved in the end. A wise person once told me that. Alright, so let's see what I got in here. Hopefully this doesn't get flagged because this is going, you can hear the beck pretty loud in the background, but play a show tonight solo. Now, I already have a copy of this, so don't laugh at me, but you know what? I love this album so much. I was like, if I could get another copy for a decent deal, I should. And, so it's, I guess I want to make sure it wasn't going to... So yeah, got another copy of Julian Priester. This one, little corner is a little beat up, but it said the album itself is VG, I think, plus. So we'll give it a look over. They said it was in really good condition. I mean, see what I'm saying? This is how OCD we've gotten. It's a good condition. Stoked. Has the kind of a, I think. This, I swear the other one I have is not printed in the USA. So let's hold on, let's do a little, as I like to say, a little bit of detective vinyl work here. Yes. Wow. Okay. That's kind of cool. So I have a German pressing and an American pressing. Even. Awesome. My German pressing has a really nice case. Sometimes the German pressings I feel like are a little smoother. So we'll find out on this one. Yeah, total. A different layout, also. Kind of. Either way, super stoked. Love this album. It's got the, it reminds me of the soundtrack to Phantasm. I don't know why. And yeah, I'm still kind of spaced out. Just recuperating from not feeling good. I'm almost back to crazy Thai. That is some coffee. It's not hot tea. Alright, I also got this in the mail. I already have this on CD. I have quite a few copies on vinyl now. But this was the deluxe version. I think I might... These CDs might have come with the box that I have on vinyl for the 25th anniversary. But I didn't have this deluxe edition. I possibly remember seeing this for like $5 and I probably missed out on it. But it has never before released demos and B-sides. So I want to hear some of the demos. Anyways, let's give this one a little open. Find a spot I can shank the plastic. Okay. They did. The way they put this in the mailbox, I almost shank myself. It's, you know, sometimes these things they just make. Sometimes it just is impossible. I got this knife pointed at my face like. Freaking Freddy Krueger. I want to save this hype. Just finish your hype stick. Okay. That took way too long. I was curious if the CD is the same color as the original one. Okay, this case already. So there's just a bunch of slips, and you gotta slide the CD out. Okay, wait. No, Okay, original album remastered. It is a different color. It's got this. The original one had clear with the, had like a yellow. A yellow silver. Either way, should have showed you this right off the back. Anyways, nothing too crazy. Pretty much similar to same picture that's on the 25th anniversary album box set. Anyways, this album was a game changer when it came out. He was like another good singer besides Eddie Vedder and Chris Cornell. All the singers are really good in the grunge era. I think that's what's cool about the grunge era, I guess. All the musicianship. All right, cheers, everybody. Stay positive. Play lots of vinyl. I'm coming up on my year anniversary. I'm being on the YouTube. So that's pretty cool. Anyways, throw a comment if you got any of this stuff. Laters.